Welcome to the PREEvision Systems Engineering tutorial. Together, we will develop a robot vacuum cleaner using the RFLP approach. PREEvision's comprehensive MBSE toolset will demonstrate how clean systems engineering can be. Are you ready? Great. Let's start with the requirements as the basis for our development. The first part of our tutorial series focuses on requirements engineering as the first step in the systems engineering process. This step gives everyone involved a shared understanding of the system that will be developed. We will create and edit requirements, set up traceability, and create test items for the verification of the requirements. We will follow the RFLP systems engineering model, starting with the requirements for the system, software, and hardware. At the system level, we distinguish between stakeholder requirements and system requirements. Now let's go to PREEvision and take a look at the current development of our robot vacuum cleaner. The Systems Engineering Explorer provides categories for stakeholder requirements and system requirements. Stakeholder requirements describe the product's benefits for one or more stakeholders. For example, the robot should not knock over vases or other objects on the floor. Therefore, we need a maneuver strategy for objects in the room. Since stakeholders are often not technical experts, these features are formulated in natural language. However, we can also use use case diagrams to depict use cases, their dependencies, and the different stakeholders. Here, we have the owner as the user of the robot vacuum cleaner. However, a roommate could also use the cleaner. So let's add a roommate as a potential user and thereby a stakeholder. Click on Use Case Actor in the palette and click in the diagram to create the actor. Let's call him roommate and connect him as a generalization to the user. These non-technical requirements are then broken down into system requirements. One example. We would like to create a system requirement that the robot must be able to handle animal traffic while moving. We select the chapter Operating and click the button to create a requirement. You will notice that the requirements editor looks and works just the same for stakeholder requirements as it does for system requirements. We can format the text, for example, highlight important terms, and even add images. I just realized that there is a dedicated chapter for advisories, so we will simply move it to the chapter with the safety requirements, where I drag and drop. Now we want to clarify that the new system requirement is derived from the collision avoidance requirement. PREEvision provides a table to easily link system requirements to stakeholder requirements. This table displays all stakeholder requirements on the left. All system requirements are on the right. Now we simply pick our system requirement and drop it on collision avoidance. This creates a bidirectional link that establishes traceability, which will later be extended by linking requirements to software and hardware components that fulfill them. PREEvision provides many traceability editors, all of which work the same way. You set up traceability via drag and drop. The editor indicates missing linking targets with a yellow highlight. Ambiguous links are highlighted in blue. Unexpected links that should be cut are highlighted in red. Since requirements engineering is an ongoing task that continues throughout the development process, highlighting such gaps is very useful. To ensure that the new requirement is implemented correctly later, we can define a collision avoidance test now. Select the test data package to open the test specification editor. Under Advisories, we create a new test item. We enter a name. Then we define a precondition for the test. In the description, we define the expected behavior. Now we want to clarify which requirement this test is relevant to. We open the link to the test specification. Our requirement is on the left. On the right, we see our test. we simply drop the requirement on the test item. Adding a single test item is very easy. Creating test items for a complete requirements structure is not much harder. Let's get to the stakeholder requirements for the mobile phone app. There is a test specification defined for the app. We can now structure the test specification very easily according to the requirements. A click on the button Clone Specification Structure creates test headings in parallel to the requirement headings. It is now very easy to keep our test specification tidy, mirroring the requirements. What we just did at the system level also works at the software and hardware levels. For software, we can define requirements and corresponding tests. We can also link these requirements to system requirements, tests, or software components. The same applies to the hardware. In each category, you will find similar editors that work the same way. That's it for the requirements viewpoint of our tutorial series. In the second part, we will take the requirements and start designing a system that includes its structure, behavior, and specific functions. See you there. And one more thing. If you'd like to try it out for yourself while watching the other parts of the tutorial, go for it. We offer PREEvision as a hosted environment so you can check it out. There, you can interact directly with the MBSE demo model and experiment. If you are interested, please visit PREEvision.com/trial. Thanks for watching.